Welcome students, in today's lecture we are going to start the explanation of the essay My Future Wife, written by William Cobbett. In this essay, Cobbett tells the reader that how he met his wife and why he became attracted towards her, okay, and what were the qualities in her behavior that impressed him. So now let us begin the essay. When I first saw my wife, she was 13 years old and I was within about a month of 21. So Cobbett tells the reader that when he first saw his wife, she was 13 years old, okay, and he himself was about 21 year old. She was the daughter of a sergeant of artillery and I was the sergeant major of a regiment of foot. She was the daughter of a sergeant of artillery. Sergeant is a rank in army, okay, and artillery is armed forces that uses weapons, okay. So she was the daughter of a sergeant of artillery unit of army and he was at the post of sergeant major. And the author was at the post of sergeant major of a regiment of foot. Regiment is a unit of army. Okay. Regiment of foot. That means he was at the post of sergeant major of a regiment of foot. Regiment is a unit of army. It's a army unit. Okay. Both stationed in forts near the city of San Juan, in the province of New Brunswick. And both of these army units, the unit of artillery and the regiment of foot, okay, the both of these army units were stationed in forts near the city of St. John in the province of Brunswick. Province means you can say region, kshetra. Okay, so they were stationed in forts near the city of St. John in the province of Brunswick. I sat in the same room with her for about an hour in company with others and I made up my mind that she was the very girl for me. So he tells the reader that he sat in the same room with that girl for an hour, but there were many other people too with them and at that point of time he decided immediately that she was the right girl for him. Okay, that I thought her beautiful is certain, for that I had always said should be an indispensable qualification, but I saw in her what I deemed marks of that sobriety of conduct of which I have said so much. So he tells the reader that he sat in the same room with her for an hour. So it was love at first sight. Okay, both the author and the girl's father were in army and their troops were stationed at the same place. Once the author and the girl sat in the same room for an hour and immediately he decided that she was the perfect a girl for him. Next he tells us that he thought this girl beautiful because according to him being beautiful was an absolutely necessary qualification that a girl must have. Okay, that means according to him a girl must be beautiful. Here he's saying that it is an indispensable qualification, that means absolutely necessary qualification that a girl should have. Okay, but I saw in her what I deemed marks of that sobriety of conduct of which I have said so much. He found her beautiful, but besides that he saw in her marks of seriousness of behavior. Sobriety means you can say seriousness of conduct of behavior. Okay, disciplined she was. Okay, he saw in her marks of seriousness of behavior about which he had said so much, and which has been by far the greatest blessing of my life. And this kind of behavior has been by far the greatest blessing of his life. Okay. He wants to tell the reader that no doubt the girl was pretty. Okay. But besides being beautiful, the thing that attracted him towards her was her seriousness of behavior and her manners. It was now dead of winter, and of course the snow several feet deep on the ground and the weather piercing cold. It was now dead of winter, that means it was intensely cold weather, okay? And of course the snow was several feet deep on the ground. It was snow everywhere and the weather was extremely cold. It was my habit, when I had done my morning's writing, to go out at break of day to take a walk on a hill at the foot of which our barracks lay. Now he tells us that after he had done his morning's writing, he used to go for a walk on a hill at the time of sunrise. So this author Cobbett was working as a clerk too. That is why he had a writing session at early morning. After writing, he had a habit of going for a walk on a hill at the foot of which their barracks were situated. Barracks means their you can say camps, military camps were situated. Okay, so their camp was situated at the foot of a hill where he used to go for a walk at the time of sunrise. In about 3 mornings after I had first seen her, I had, by an invitation to breakfast with me, got up 2 young men to join me in my walk, and our road lay by the house of her father and mother. After 3 mornings, when he had first seen that girl, he invited 2 young men to join him at breakfast. Okay, and when they were going for the breakfast, on their way, there was the house of her parents. There was the house of her mother and father, that means her parents. Okay. It was hardly light, but she was out on the snow, scrubbing out a washing tub. That's the girl for me. So it was the time of before sunrise, or you can say it was the time of early morning, and that girl was working on the snow and she was scrubbing out a washing tub. In that intense cold weather, that girl was working. That means she was a really hard working person. Okay, and when they reached, that's the girl for me, said I, when we had got out of her hearing. Now he's saying that when they reached at a safe distance from where she could not hear them, the author said, that's the girl for me. Okay. One of these young men came to England soon afterwards, and he, who keeps an inn in Yorkshire, came over to Preston at the time of the election to verify whether I were the same man. Now, one of these young men came to England soon afterwards. Here, he is talking about the guys whom he invited on the breakfast that morning when they saw that girl scrubbing the washing tub. Okay, and one of these young men, who is an innkeeper in Yorkshire, once came to Preston, England, where the author was living at that time. Okay, so this young man came to meet the author, and he was surprised to see him there. When he found that he appeared surprised. But what was his surprise when I told him that those tall young men whom he saw around me were the sons of that pretty little girl that he and I saw scrubbing out the washing tub on the snow in the New Brunswick at daybreak in the morning. So this one of these young men came to meet the author in England, and he was surprised to see him there. But he was more surprised when the author told him that those tall young men whom he just saw around the author, they were sons of that pretty girl that he and the author saw scrubbing the tub on the snow in New Brunswick. Okay, so this incident that the author is presenting before us, it happened later in his life when he had eventually married that girl. Okay, and when his old friend came to meet him in England, he was surprised to see that the author married the same girl that he saw that morning. From the day that I first spoke to her, I never had a thought of her being the wife of any other man, more than I had a thought of her being transformed into a chest of drawers. He tells us that the day that he first spoke to that pretty little girl, he at once decided that she is going to be his future wife. Okay, and he could not imagine her being wife of any other man. And this thought was very weird and impossible for him. Okay, and it was like imagining her being transformed into a chest of drawers. It was like imagining her being transformed into a furniture. Okay, chest of drawer is a kind of furniture. Okay, so this thought about her being married to someone else was totally impossible for him. I formed my resolution at once to marry her as soon as we could get permission and to get out of the army as soon as I could. He made his decision at once to marry that girl as soon as they both could get permission to marry. Okay, and he also decided to get out of the army as soon as he could. Okay. So that this matter was at once settled as firmly as if written in the book of fate. So in these lines, Cobbett is telling the reader that when he first saw that girl, he was really attracted towards her. But gradually, when they both started talking, he immediately decided to marry that girl because he found her perfect for himself. So this matter was fixed immediately, and the decision was as firm as if it was written in the book of fate. That means it was like as if being married to that girl was written in his fate. Fate means bhagya. Okay. At the end of about 6 months, my regiment and I along with it were removed to Fredericton, a distance of 100 miles up the river of St. John, and which was worse, the artillery were expected to go off to England a year or two before our regiment. So what happened next? Author tells the reader in these lines of his essay. He tells us that after 6 months, he and his regiment was removed to Fredericton, and this place was at the distance of 100 miles up the river of St. John. Okay, then the worst happened. The artillery, in which the girl's father was a sergeant, were going back to England a year or two before author's regiment. Okay, so author was in the regiment of foot, and girl's father was a sergeant in artillery. First, they both were posted at the same place. Okay, then author's regiment was removed to 100 miles away, and then the artillery unit was sent back to England a year or two before the regiment of foot in which the author was posted. Okay, the artillery went, and she along with them. And now it was that I acted a part, becoming a real and sensible lover. The artillery went back to England, and the girl along with them, because her father was in artillery unit of army, so she had to go. Okay, it was that I acted a part, becoming a real and sensible lover. When the author and that girl got separated, it was then that he started becoming a real and sensible lover. Distance taught him true value of that girl in his life. Okay. I was aware that when she got to that gay place, Woolwich, the house of her father and mother, necessarily visited by numerous persons, not the most select, might become unpleasant to her, and I did not like, besides, that she should continue to work hard. Next, he says that he already knew that when she will be living to that place named Woolwich. Woolwich was headquarters of the Royal Artillery near London. Okay, he already knew that when she will be living to that place, her house will be necessarily visited by numerous persons. That means they will definitely have several visitors in their house, and the author already knew that. Not the most select, might become unpleasant to her, and I did not like, besides that she should continue to work hard. And these visitors are not going to be the best ones, okay? Most select, that means they are not going to be the best ones. There will be different kinds of persons visiting her house. And the girl might become unpleasant with it. That means the author was concerned that at this new place where the girl's family started living, there will be so many visitors at their home. And he was not happy about it, okay? Besides that, he did not like that she should continue to work hard, okay? I had saved 150 guineas, the earning of my early hours in writing for the paymaster, the quartermaster and others, in addition to the savings of my own pay. So the author decided to give the girl all of his savings. He tells us that he was earning some extra money by writing for others. He was writing for the paymaster, quartermaster and others. Okay, he tells the reader that he was earning some extra money by writing for others, and he was writing for the paymaster. Paymaster is an official who pays troops or workers. And the quartermaster, he was also writing for the quartermaster and some other persons. He used to write for other people to earn some extra money. So the author sent the girl all his money before she sailed back to England. I sent her all my money before she sailed, and wrote to her to beg of her, if she found her home uncomfortable, to hire a lodging with respectable people. He says that he sent the girl all of his money before she sailed back to England. He also wrote to her and requested her that if she found her home uncomfortable, she can hire some other place to live with some respectable people. Cobbett thought that this girl was not happy at her home because she had to work really hard there. Okay, so he sent her money so that she could hire some other place to live and where she could live comfortably. Okay. And at any rate, not to spare the money by any means, but to buy herself good clothes and to live without hard work until I arrived in England. And I, in order to induce her to lay out the money, told her that I should get plenty more before I came home. He also wrote to her that at any cost, at any rate, she should not save this money, but she should buy some good clothes for herself. She should spend this money to live at a comfortable place where she need not to work hard. Okay. And author also wrote to her that she can easily spend this whole money before he arrives in England. And in order to induce her to spend that money, he told her that when he will reach England, he will definitely have a plenty more of money. Okay. So he wanted to convince her to spend that whole money. As the malignity of the devil would have it, we were kept abroad 2 years longer than our time. Mr. Pitt, having knocked up a dust with Spain at Nootka Sound, England not being so tame then as she is now. Tame means calm. Okay. So Cobbett now tells us that as an army person, he was posted abroad. Abroad means some foreign country. He was posted abroad 2 years longer than the expected time. That means, unfortunately, hear this line, as malignity of devil, that means, unfortunately, he was kept on duty 2 years longer than he expected. Okay. And what was the reason? Because Mr. Pitt, here you can see, Mr. Pitt, who was Mr. Pitt? He was the Prime Minister of England at that time. Okay. Because Mr. Pitt was having a quarrel with Spain about Nootka Sound. And that is the reason that he had to serve in army 2 years longer than expected. Okay. Oh, how I curse the Nootka Sound and poor bawling Pitt too. I'm afraid. Bawling means crying. Okay. Now he says that Cobbett cursed the matter of Nootka Sound. Okay. And his crying Prime Minister Mr. Pitt too. Because they were the reason that he was apart from his love. He was apart from his future wife. Okay. At the end of 4 years, however, home I came, landed at Portsmouth, and got my discharge from the army by the great kindness of poor Lord Edward Fitzgerald. Now, after 4 years, he came home and landed at Portsmouth. He also got his discharge from the service of army by the great kindness of Lord Edward Fitzgerald, who was then major of his regiment. Okay. I found my little girl a servant of all work, and hard work it was, at £5 a year in the house of a Captain Rizek. Now, when he came back to that girl, he found that this his little girl was a servant of all work in the house of a Captain Rizek. And for her hard work, she was earning only £5 a year. Okay. And without hardly saying a word about the matter, she put into my hands the whole of my 150 guineas unbroken. And she did not tell anything about the matter to him. And she put into his hand the whole money, 105 guineas that he has sent her before. That means she did not spend the money at all. And she returned the whole money back to him. Okay. Need I tell the reader what my feelings were? Need I tell kind-hearted English parents what effect this anecdote must have produced on the minds of our children? Next, he says that he tells us that reader can easily understand his feelings at that point of time. Okay, and he was highly impressed with that girl's behavior. He says, need, here is a typing mistake, okay, this is need, N-E-E-D, need. Need I tell kind-hearted English parents what effect this anecdote must have produced on the minds of our children? He says that all the kind-hearted parents can understand what effect this beautiful story of ours must have produced on minds of our children. That means it was very inspiring story for their children as well. Okay. need, it's need, N-E-E-D, okay. Need attempt to describe what effect this example ought to have on every young woman who shall do me the honor to read this book. Now he says he need not to tell the reader what effect this example must have on every young woman who is going to read this book of author. That means every young woman should get inspiration from this example of his wife. Okay. Admiration of her conduct and self-gratulation on this indubitable proof of the soundness of my judgment were now added to my love of her beautiful person. Now he says that he became absolutely sure about his own judgment about that girl, and this behavior of her was unquestionable proof. Indubitable proof means unquestionable proof of that. Okay. He says that before he was in love with her good personality, but now he was very impressed with this girl's behavior, this girl's conduct, manners, and her self-gratulation. Gratulation means a feeling of happiness and satisfaction at one's own good fortune. That means self-satisfaction, feeling of self-satisfaction. He was really impressed that she was self-satisfied. Okay. Now, I do not say that there are not many young women in this country who would, under similar circumstances, have acted as my wife did in this case. On the contrary, I hope and do sincerely believe there are. He says that he is not saying that there are not many young women in this country who would have acted same as his wife did in the similar circumstances. He says that he sincerely believes that there are many young women who would have acted the same in the same situation. Okay. But when her age is considered, when we reflect that she was living in a place crowded, literally crowded, and with gaily dressed and handsome young men, many of whom really far richer and in higher rank. Now he says that, but when we her age is considered, when this little girl's age is considered, it was really impressive. Okay. Because she was living in a crowded place. Author tells us that this girl was living in a crowded place where there were many handsome, well-dressed, gaily dressed, that means well-dressed young men, okay? And these young men were really far richer and higher in rank than the author. But still, she kept her loyalty towards him. Okay. Then I was, and scores of them, scores means many of them, okay, are ready to offer her their hand. When we reflect that she was living amongst young women who put up on their backs every shilling that they could come at. Now he says there were too many young men ready to offer her their hand, but she still waited for him. Okay. She still waited for Cobbett. Okay. He says that she was living amongst young women who put up on their backs every shilling that they could come at. He tells us that girl was living amongst a young woman who would do anything for money. But she was the girl who never touched the bag of gold that she was offered. We see that her keeping the bag of gold untouched and working hard to provide herself with but mere necessary apparel, and doing this while she was passing from 15 to 18 years of age. He says that she was the girl who never touched the bag of gold that she was offered by the author. and she worked hard to provide herself with mere necessary clothes. Okay. And all these things, all of these things she did while she was passing from 14 to 18 years of age. You can not expect such good behavior, such good conduct from a teenager. That is why author was so impressed with this girl. When we view the whole of the circumstances, we must say that here is an example which, while it reflects honor on her sex, ought to have weight with every young woman whose eyes or ears this relation shall reach. He says that when we view the whole of the situation, we must say that this example of his wife provides honor to all females out there. Okay? Honor on her sex, that means all females out there. Okay? And each and every young woman should get inspiration from this example of his wife. So here ends the essay. Thank you so much for watching.